new perspective. Well, have you learned anything, Dad, dear?
Well, you have to learn to be patient because it takes you a lot longer to do the same thing that you used to do. I take a nap during the day for an hour or two, and I just thought today, I used to teach two math classes during the time I'm taking this nap. And now I can't even keep up my yard. The weeds are growing, it's pretty bad out there. You just go on, you just do the best you can. Try to endure faithfully to the end.
Well, we're very, very thankful that we're as well as we are in our age. Pat's 91, I'm 90. We have our little aches and pains and our little problems, but nothing so far serious enough that we're going to die from it.
Well, when people ask me how I am, and I always say, very well, thank you. But very well is different than it was when I was young and felt the way I do now. Often I would stay home because I was sick. Now it's just the way it is. It's interesting watching yourself grow less able, lose physical ability. You know, you have hearing aids and glasses, and you know, it's like a junkyard.
Fixing up your car, huh?
Some of the things aren't recognizable, some don't work. You do the best you can. But I discovered in teaching that you have to love those you teach, or you can't really teach them.
Well, that's what they teach the missionaries, of course, too. But teachers have to do that, too.
Yeah.
I'll talk about all your grandchildren and great-grandchildren and your posterity now. How many are there, tell
them? Oh, well, we only have 6 children, 34 grandchildren.
We've lost 2 of them.
2 of those, yeah.
Grandchildren.
And 78 great-grandchildren with 5 on the way.
2 sets of twins on the way.
On the way.
And we have several sets of twins.
If you keep on having twins, you're going to double in the next 5 years.
So we already have a few. So they're up to 75 or 76.
It's amazing.
It's amazing when you live a little longer, you see.
Already see your posterity grow. Yeah.
Well, it's interesting to hear people talk about history, and we were there. You know, they talk about the Second World War. We lived through it.
Yeah.
I served in it. That's history to most of the people, young people we talked with. They don't realize that they're talking about stuff we lived through. That's a unique experience. For a lot of years in my profession, I was the youngest one. And all of a sudden, I was the oldest one. Seemed like it happened overnight. But it's good to know that the gospel's true. That Joseph actually had the visitation of the Savior and the Lord and the Father, that the Book of Mormon is true. It's good to know that God lives and Jesus is the Christ.
Talk a little louder.
The promised Messiah of the Old Testament, the Savior and Redeemer of the world. And I'm grateful to know that he will be my advocate with the Father, because I'm going to need a lot of help.